Hey folks, how's it going? So I've made some progress with this Hulk model kit. The first thing I did was cut off all the excess flesh. There was a hell of a lot of that to do. It was fairly easy though, because vinyl's really easy to cut, so I just cut that stuff straight off and then sanded it down. Get a nice flat surface on the bits that were necessary to do that, and then next step was to fill it. Now I filled this entire thing with milliput. I used 11 packs of the stuff, so it's solid and quite heavy now actually as well. I wanted this thing to have a bit of weight because it is a huge model. I wanted it to be really strong and sturdy. So 11 packs of milliput went into it, and it's just given me a really solid base to pin and drill and stuff like that, which I've actually started to do. On the legs here, these lower sections of the legs were separate, and then the top sections had these like areas that sunk into the lower sections here, so that gave me a good place to drill all the way around and then pin as well. So these are totally secure now. Also, I epoxied them before I drilled and everything like that too. So, yeah, the lower parts of the legs are really solid, which is important because this top part of it now is really, really heavy. So I need really secure base for it to go into. The next step will be to put the torso on here. Now, an issue I noticed with that is that the waistband here is slightly misshapen. I don't know if that's from the casting or from storage or just from me carving out all the excess flash, if it's slightly changed the shape of it. But I've heard that you can heat up vinyl and then kind of reshape it, so I'm going to give that a try when it comes time to do that. But yeah, obviously I'll pin the torso to the legs as well. And then also I'm going to pin the arms on as well. Because at the moment there's just like flat surfaces on each, so I'm going to epoxy the arms on and then drill holes straight through the shoulders and put big pins right into the chest here, so they'll hopefully be as solid as they possibly can be. So yeah, that's the kind of, as I say, it's slow progress, but I've been busy with a whole bunch of other stuff. But yeah, so once I've assembled it all, it'll be a case of filling any gaps that remain, like around the waistband here, if I'm not able to get a super tight fit with the heating up and reshaping. There's quite a bit of filling work to do as well. There was some air bubbles in the waistband here, and just general filling and stuff as well. But after that's done, I think I'm going to try and create some kind of base for it. I'm not entirely sure what I'm doing yet. I think I'll kind of make it up as I go along and see what looks good. But yeah, want to do something, big and kind of interesting looking as well. So it's not just on a plain, base or whatever. But yeah, and then it'll be on to the paint stage. So I'll come back and show you what's going on when I'm moving on to that. But yeah, until then, cheers for watching, and I will catch you all later. Goodbye.